tricky one to answer because I wasn't really there for the original scene. I caught it around the late 90s, I suppose, or I started to like the music in the early 90s, but I didn't get anywhere near the scene until much later. There's been a lot of changes, and of course some of the purists in the scene really don't like the fact that things evolve, but it's spread around the world, which means that the sound has started to evolve in all kinds of interesting ways, and we're starting to hear different cultural influences affecting the sound, which is, in my opinion, a great thing because it, you know, it opens new doors and it stops things becoming stale. So, for example, there's a band called Bliss Illusion from China, and they are doing this kind of post-black metal sound, but very much with their own cultural influence upon it. And it's a completely different thing from anything that would have come out of Europe. It's a little bit like how Sepultura took the metal sound and added this Brazilian twist to it, and it just became something amazing. And so I'm hoping to hear much more of that kind of thing, to see what other interesting ways the sound can be manipulated and how it can evolve. So that's something that's definitely different. It's attracted a different group of people than probably would have liked it in the original days, which is for better or for worse, because on the one hand you get different perspectives and, like I said, you get these different cultural influences. But on the other hand, you also get a contingent of people who are what I would call tourists, who want to take what black metal is and sanitize it and make it safer and more acceptable. And honestly, they're kind of missing the point. That's not what it's about. If that's what you're looking for, this is really not the place for you. So it's difficult for me to talk about new music generally, because the vast majority of what I listened to was music written between 1850 and 1970. But I have discovered a few new things lately. There's a band called Decoherence who I really like. It's black metal, but it's great for the gym because it just puts my mind in a different universe. There are other bands who have that. I like this huge, spacey, hypnotic black metal sound. So that's something. Decoherence. What's that other band called? The Great Old Ones, I think. This Cthulhu mythos kind of black metal thing. I like what they do a lot as well. The new Cannibal Corpse album is great. I've only heard it one time, but that's something that I've been enjoying. I want to go back to that. Apart from that, there's a lot of non-metal, because obviously one thing that you have to understand for all of us within the band, we hear metal all the time. So when we're not at work and we're not inside metal, sometimes you need a break from it. You need to get your head into a different kind of music. Now, I have a lot of, you know, the classical music stuff that I like. But then there's also other things like Diankvort or Zardonic, the drum and bass DJ. It's wide ranging, it depends on my mood, but definitely in terms of metal, the new music I've been getting into is very much this hypnotic black metal sound.
We have been making plans since March last year, but they keep on getting moved or cancelled. We have plans, but we have no idea if they are ever going to happen. Who the hell knows, right? We just sit on our ass, rotting and waiting for this shit to be over so we can start touring again and show our music for you guys. We want to go out and play. That and more living a normal life fucking sucks.